All the cells in our bodies are derived from cells in the early embryo called pluripotent cells. And our group is interested in studying what controls the identity and functional characteristics of these cells. We're interested in the classic pluripotent cell type, the so-called embryonic stem cell, and also the more developmentally advanced epiblast stem cell. We want to know how ES cells change their identity and become epiblast stem cells. And we also want to know how it's possible to switch the identity of epiblast stem cells back into an ES cell state. Now, one of the key focuses of the lab is on gene regulators that control cell identity. So some years ago, we identified a particular gene regulator that we call an OG as a molecule that was able to maintain the identity of embryonic stem cells with high efficiency. We want to know how this molecule works. We want to know what other proteins it interacts with in order to deliver its function. We want to know what genes this molecule acts on, both to activate their expression or to repress their expression, and how those particular target genes act to deliver embryonic stem cell identity. Now, one of the things that we found a few years ago was that not all embryonic stem cells express NOG. And we're interested in understanding how cells that express NOG lose that capacity. And we also showed that cells that had lost expression of NOG could be switched back into the NOG expressing cell state. This is shown on this photomicrograph here. So what you're looking at here is a colony of mostly undifferentiated embryonic stem cells. The cells that express the NOG are marked in green, and the cells that express a particular target of the NOG are also marked by expression of this red protein. So we can use these kinds of cells that we've engineered to dissect apart the dynamics of the cell behaviour from cells that express both NOG and its target, to cells that express only NOG, and to cells that express neither NOG or its target. And these cells here are the cells that are about to commit into differentiation, and this then gives us a rounded picture of what ES cell identity means and produces cells that other groups in the Institute can study to understand better differentiation processes.